Hello everyone, I'm back with yet another RimWorld video. I've been getting a handful of comments asking for more RimWorld tips, and I'm sorry to disappoint, but I don't really have a whole lot more highest quality tips to share. So today I'm going to share some relatively common tips. Most of these are well known within the RimWorld community, so feel free to maybe share this video with a friend who doesn't frequent the RimWorld subreddit. Alright, let's start with the first tip of the video. The best armor in terms of defense is a full set of cataphract armor with hyperweave clothing. But getting cataphract armor is pretty rare, and hyperweave is even harder to find. So instead, here's the most practical loadout. Uranium flak helmet, flak vest, and Devilstrand face mask, duster, button-down shirt, and pants. This loadout is fairly cheap to make and offers great protection. You can make adjustments to this loadout, such as using royalty capes or flak pants instead, but generally speaking, this is what you should be using until your colony is drowning in resources. And even then, you will probably see more benefit from crafting bionics before power armor. There are three ranged weapons in the game that are tied for the best, depending on your chosen playstyle. These are the charge rifle, assault rifle, and chain shotgun. The charge rifle is best for a killbox defense setup. It has high damage and armor penetration, but its shorter range makes it a poor choice for many open engagements. The assault rifle has the highest range in the game, save for the slow and impractical sniper rifle. It has high damage but lower armor penetration, making a killbox setup more risky versus high armor targets. The best use of the assault rifle is for kiting enemies outside of your base, but be wary of pirate snipers. The chain shotgun does significantly higher damage than any other weapon in the game, absolutely shredding anything that comes within range. But it's really only practical using a shotgun tunnel defense. Each of these weapons have a glaring weakness, so make sure you're prepared appropriately for whatever that may be. And by prepare, I mean use a ton of mortars. I love drugs. In RimWorld, beer and psychite tea are both very useful and relatively safe to consume. You should make these for your colony to use. Ambrosia is really valuable, so you should sell it rather than consume it. Yayo is the emergency mood drug, Go Juice is the run fast drug, and Wake Up is the immediate productivity drug. All pawns should carry one Yayo, all soldiers should carry one Go Juice, and all workers should carry one Wake Up. Luciferium is good for any pawn, but best for your melee fighters. Flake is generally worse than Yayo, just sell it. Phenoxacillin is basically useless, so just sell it. And lastly, Smoke Leaf is absolutely terrible for your pawns. It makes your pawns worse at everything, and can actually kill them if their consciousness is low enough. Use this on prisoners to sedate them, or just sell it. Definitely do not bother crafting this. Don't sleep on field stoves and smithies. These will only consume fuel while in use, while their electric variants constantly drain power, even while idle. Electric benches also cost components to make, while the fueled ones only cost steel. The fueled benches will also work during a solar flare, so you can keep your colony fed. The electric benches are really only better if wood is a scarcity on your map. Hydroponics can be used without sun lamps. They are weather resistant, have double the fertility of fertile soil, and they have relatively low power consumption. You can use them to line your pathways like this, making the farms easily accessible to your pawns, and improves pawn pathing by keeping them walking on the paths instead of dirt. On the flip side, sun lamps can be used without hydroponics. This allows you to grow Devilstrand indoors, and is significantly cheaper resource-wise when compared to a traditional hydroponic setup. These next two tips are mainly for the Royalty DLC. Smoke will make your pawns undetectable by enemy turrets. This applies to both mech turrets and pirate turrets. Smoke launchers are best for this, since they have infinite ammo, but a high-quality smoke pop belt or psycast will work as well. When facing a mech cluster with unstable power cells, use a uranium breach axe to destroy turrets. Breach axes deal significant damage to buildings, and you'll typically be able to destroy turrets without an unwanted explosion. These last two tips are specific to the Ideology DLC. When creating your Ideologian, you should always add the precept Child Labor Disapproved. This gives your colony children a +20% increase to learning. Children are still allowed to perform work, you just can't use the yellow work blocks in their schedule, at least not without causing a mood penalty to your colony. Cannibal platters are more useful than at first glance. They allow for the cannibal feast ritual, which by itself is great and I recommend having, but they are also a great way to store human meat. Simply place the blueprint and have your colonists provide the resources, and then forbid it to prevent construction. The meat will not spoil, and you can simply cancel the construction anytime you want for a full refund. You could also let the buildings complete, which allows you to move and uninstall them, but you'll only get half of the meat back when you deconstruct it. And that's all the tips I have for today. If you learned something new, or want me to make more RimWorld tips videos, please let me know down in the comments below. If I made any mistakes, I will pin a comment with corrections, so keep an eye out for that. And that's going to do it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.